biggest questions we get is, how do I know what to ask GPT-3 to generate? Because sometimes you can see what you want to get, but you can't really figure out what the code is underneath. So not everyone is a coder. And so to solve this problem, we implemented this no-code helper, and actually eventually it'll just directly plug into the GPT-3 generator. But what it does is you can hover over the specific thing that you're looking for, right? Your data that you're trying to extract, or the button you're trying to push, for example, and it'll tell you the type of element that it is. So for example, this one is H2, and it'll give you some of its attributes, which you can use as a selector. So for example, you could say, find all the H2 on the page with a class that includes dark text. And let's try that. Or dark text. We'll find out. Okay, cool. There's H2 and dark dash text. Okay. And that is indeed what we did. Let's not wait 5 seconds. And let's alert it instead. Cool. So you can see the data that we were trying to extract was this header, install and setup, back to the top, and we exactly figured it out. Oh, it's going to get all of them. It's getting all the headers. Okay. So that's kind of useful. So we could stop at the first one if we wanted. Yeah. So that's how you use the new features in CheatLayer. All you have to do is enable CheatLayer using the icon and hover over whatever you want to extract, and it'll give you the information you need to do it, or at least what to ask GPT-3. In a future update, we'll just let you click, and then it'll automatically generate the words that you need to